set for encounters with power. It must not be an ordinary month for anyone here. It's a month of new beginnings, a month of new chapters. In the name of Jesus Christ, we have prayed. Give the Lord a big hand and please you may be seated. Every opportunity to serve, every opportunity to serve is just a privilege. And it must not be taken lightly. For all of us who are CEL or WSF officials, in a moment we're going to have our attendance register filled out. And I'm sure the forms are here. They're not here, okay. So please pick a piece of paper. Cut a little piece of paper to help us fill out the details we normally have every Saturday when we gather together. Praise God. It's always once in a month, and it's the first Saturday of every month, and it's to get us prepared for what the month holds. Please, you don't have a piece of paper, ask your neighbor if he can spare you one. And fix your name, your cell, your zone, and your district. Praise the Lord. The Youth Alive Convention ended yesterday. Oh, yesterday night. Great time. In God's presence by all participants, and may the blessings remain. Amen. May the blessings continue to multiply. Amen. Zechariah chapter 7 verse 13, as I've cried and they will not hearken, so they will cry and I will not listen. Therefore it came to pass that as he cried and they will not hear, so they cried and I will not hear, said the Lord of hosts. Only those who take God serious can secure his attention. You take him lightly, he takes you lightly. You despise him, he despises you. I've said it before, please let all cell ministers take responsibility. If there's an empowerment summit like this and you are not going to be there, there must be clear indication to the authority over you that you are out of town or you are on an assignment somewhere else, so it can be noted. A 19-year-old chap by name Matthew Gold was a cell minister, formed a little team of two others with him, and built the cell that was dying to 41 membership. And God rewarded him openly and change his level forever. Let all seminars accept responsibility for these 2 months remaining in the fifth phase of the Wonder Double Prophetic Agenda, the month of August and the month of September. We are launching the new operation tomorrow morning, and in the name of Jesus Christ, it shall be a most fruitful operation for you. You shall deliver unthinkable results. Amen. As you get yourself genuinely committed to this cause. Can I tell you this? You are only as relevant as you make yourself to be. He has better hands than you and me. One thing God told me at the beginning is that I have not chosen you because you are better or smarter than others. I have only given you a privilege. And should you abuse it, there are better hundreds at the door. Don't sit down somewhere and think that if I'm not there, then who will do it? Better hundreds. Better hundreds. One of my new converts brought six others. Better hundreds. Better hundreds at the door. The same way we have had to remove some zonal ministers who did not obey the last instruction. We remove any self-minister. Nobody's begging you to do it. You are doing it for your own good. And if you are not doing it, get out neatly. Politely. Politely. There's something special about you or me. We are only privileged. Praise God. We are only privileged. See it as a privilege. And see yourself as serving the cause of Christ, not serving a church, not serving a man. And God sees everything. He knows what you are thinking. He knows how some of you are saying, enough. Did I beg you to come? No. I've served God with singleness of heart all my life, and He's blessing me. It's blessing me. There are many people in this place, they are under that blessing permanently because their heart is pure. Their motives are pure. They are not pulling their shoulders. Fill out those cards. We normally use them. I mean, before tomorrow evening, all the data is complete. Praise God. And we use them to help us in making our decisions. So many will be excused from this service. Praise God. Any service that does not bring you any reward, ask yourself whether you are doing it right. Whether your motive is pure. Maybe you are reacting to your zonal minister. How can he be my zonal minister? Pride. Jesus made himself of no reputation. He scaled the utmost height. He scaled the utmost height. I was, as it were, leading a cell that included the chief justice of the state as a young person. Everybody was having the best of time in that platform. It's not about age. It's about divine appointment. Praise God. 19-year-old SSE student that had no money to buy form for JAMB. Had no money to buy form for JAMB. Is now in US by engaging the WSF platform for her for his change of story. Somebody's change of story will happen this time. Yeah. Before the next 2 months is over, you are singing a new song. So, be serious in your work with God. Be serious in your engagement with the assignment. Be serious in your engagement with the assignment. Don't take any task casually or you get nothing out of it. It's only the word of them that diligently, the word diligent, they are put seriously. It's the word of them that seriously serve him. I told the young people from Deuteronomy 28 verse 1, if you will seriously hearken to the voice of the Lord your God, that's the word diligent, it doesn't mean running up and down. If you will seriously hearken to the voice of the Lord your God and observe to do what he tells you to do, he will set you on high above all nations of the earth. So it is your degree of seriousness that determines his response. Your reward demands seriousness. You are not serious, you are not qualified for it. Hebrews chapter 11 verse 6. You are not serious, you are not qualified for it. Men and brethren, I've ever taken God serious in my life. All my friends from my teenage days know anything about God engages me more than any other thing in the world. It's a reward of them that seriously seek him. Seriously serve him. Okay, let's go. They say we should go. How now? How was your week? My own week was very terrible. But let's go. And then that's what we are talking to. Talk to somebody to receive Christ. He doesn't want to receive your type of Christ. Well, here is a crude boy, ever smiling. Jesus loves you. He saved me. February 16, 1969. Man, things have never been the same. And I'm not lying. I'm telling the truth. Amen. If you are not serious in your engagement, you are never entitled to rewards. If you will seriously hearken to my voice, and observe to do all I'm asking you to do seriously, then you have committed me to set you on high above all nations of the earth. Everybody here is changing levels supernaturally this season. Amen. This is the fifth phase of the wonder of prophetic agenda, and five represents grace. So I decree release of multiplied grace on your life. Yes. In the name of Jesus Christ. Yes. In the name of Jesus Christ. Yes. If you are done with your little papers, please lift them up and then ushers will pick them right now. In the name of Jesus. All cell ministers, all assistants, all pastors that are here, everybody's form is ready. Please pick those forms up in the name of Jesus Christ in 1 minute, and then we'll be ready to move into the next thing in closing this service. Praise the Lord. Now be endued with the joy of harvest. Amen. All through these weeks ahead of us in this fifth phase of the wonder of prophetic agenda, in the name of Jesus. Amen. I pray that these few weeks ahead of you will be weeks to be much remembered. Amen. Receive the spirit of servanthood. Amen. That empowers you to live above all discouragement. Amen. Receive the spirit of servanthood. Amen. That empowers you to live above all discouragement. Amen. Receive that spirit right now. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Receive that spirit right now. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. I pray that these few weeks ahead of us will be weeks of new beginnings. Amen. The spirit of wisdom will fill your heart overflowing. Amen. And in the name of Jesus, new strategies that will enhance your fruitfulness, your productivity, will be released into your life. Amen. So shall it be. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. We have been taught how to minister the Holy Ghost baptism to those who are yet to be filled, but you can't give what you don't have. So every cell minister, if there is any, there should not, but in case there is any, simply look up to Jesus. Jesus, you are the baptizer, fill me with the Holy Spirit, with the evidence of speaking with new tongues. Yes, you can call on those leaders around you. I don't want to manage this anymore. I want to be filled with the Holy Ghost, with the evidence of speaking with new tongues. And it comes in. It's important, don't fake it. It's never late to be right. I got filled with the Holy Spirit some 6 years after I was saved. So I didn't believe in it. And I thank God that he opened my eyes and I saw him as a person. And he endued me with his power. And I'm enjoying it today. 41 years after, I'm still speaking in that heavenly language with all sense of mission and direction. Somebody's changing level. Praise the Lord. If you're a cell minister and you're not baptized in water, you have a problem. The next water baptism, rush in and be baptized. I was a guest speaker in a conference when I heard the word for the first time on the importance of water baptism, and I joyfully submitted to it. They thought I came to baptize them. No, I came to be baptized. I came to be baptized. And that's part of a new beginning. You are just a cell minister. I was a guest minister in a conference. One of the co-ministers ministered on the importance of water baptism. For the first time, my eyes opened. Because I got baptized before I knew what baptism was as a baby. So I didn't have, I thought that was a no baptism. But that is bearing a mark or swimming. Until you are born again, water baptism is not relevant. Praise God. You see, nobody has a future without meekness. Nobody has a future with God without meekness. Nobody, you can be a bishop. If you are not baptized in water, you won't go to heaven. He said the Bible is not true. So you won't go there. There is no method you can use. You can't bribe God. There is no method anybody can use to make heaven without water baptism. And I'm telling you on the authority of scriptures. That's what that young minister said, that movement. There is no way, you see, at this age. Which age? It's just like you don't have a visa. You go to the airport. If they take you by mistake, you won't enter where you are going. They'll send you back from there. Sir, don't toy with it. It's part of the visa requirement for making heaven. If you are not baptized in water, the one you have before you got saved 50 years ago won't count. You need to be baptized in water after you are saved. Then you'll be saved to the uttermost. You need to be baptized in the Holy Ghost to live an overcomer's life. These are all things that, because if you are not, very shortly you'll be tired. You'll be weary. Say, what are we even doing here? You'll be tired. I've never had anything in my commitment. I've never had anything. Even when you thought nothing was happening, I've never had anything. Okay, what am I doing? I am just enjoying it. I told one of our students in Covenant University, he's graduated some 5-6 years ago. I said, did your father tell you what time I baptized him in water? He said, no, I said 11 p.m. I minister to you, you are saved. I take you to the water and baptize you there so that in case Jesus comes before the morning, you won't miss heaven. Praise God. She laughed. I said, call your father and let him know that I said I baptized him. How many want to take God serious here? Amen. And I pray that each one of us will be launched into a glorious realm of life in this fifth phase of one of the people. Not one will be left behind. As we engage in praying the prayer guidelines on supernatural church growth, prayer outlines, seriously, intensely, business-likely, and you start taking steps to see souls saved, then things will start happening. I feel prompted, and that's how the Lord prompts me, to give you an insight into what the next 5 weeks will be in this place. Amen. It is Operation Bring Many. What am I doing? Come on, let me hear you say it. What is it? Say it seriously. Now, many is not an ambiguity. We can define many from scriptures. Wherever two or three are gathered together in my name, I'm in their midst. Out of the mouth of two or three witnesses, the truth shall be established. You shall not bring any cause against any elder except by two or three witnesses. So two or three are numbered. Anything after three is where many begins. And so many means minimum four. Minimum what? Minimum what? Enough. Okay. May you not say enough to your blessings. May you never say enough to your blessings. May you never say enough to your blessings. Grace to engage maximally without despising and scorning this operation. Receive it now. Many is a cheap possibility in 5 weeks. Very cheap for serious-minded people. Not for those who are lost in the crowd. Many is no issue. Many is no issue for any serious-minded believer. To settle 4 people minimum within 5 weeks is no issue. It's no issue. And they that turn many to righteousness as the stars forever and ever. So for everyone who will go after that, your star will blossom. And they that turn many to righteousness, not to witness to them, who settles them in the faith, as the stars forever and ever. As the stars forever and ever. There is a star in every believer. There's a star inside of every believer. Until the day dawn, and the day star arises in your heart, and that star is crying for expression. And our obedience to every instruction is what empowers that star to shine. And among these instructions is turning many to righteousness. Lord, I must not make less than many in this fifth phase of the wonderful prophetic agenda. We had prayed for 1 month. We are going to reap the harvest for the next 5 weeks. And before the month of September ends, we're already celebrating the delivery of our portion. Before the month of September ends, your star is rising for all to see. Your level is changing beyond anyone's imagination. So, Operation Bring Many is from August 8th to September 18th. Amen. By the time we are ending September, we're in full-scale celebration of triumph of that. How many will say amen to that? In case they transfer you to another town, the operation continues. It's in all our churches worldwide. In case you run away to any country of the world, you'll find them there. The operation continues. Can I hear your amen? So every one of us owes Jesus minimum 4 standing souls. 4 standing souls in this operation. And you are hearing it ahead of others because you have to provide leadership into it. Can I tell you this? Every move of God is ordained for the falling, God forbid, and the rising of many. You'll be listed among the rising stars. You'll be listed among the rising stars. In the name of Jesus Christ. Stand to your feet. Lift up your 2 hands. Receive grace from heaven right now. Pray seriously. Come and tap into grace for full delivery of your part in this forthcoming operation. Come and receive that grace. Grace from heaven right now. Pray your heart out. You may have missed the operations in the past. You will not miss this one. Others have testified you are less in line. Pray that prayer. Jesus, precious name, we have prayed. By the operation 6678, we have disarmed the enemy. We have overcome him. Now let's go and divide the spoil. What are we doing? We have disarmed him. I saw the highest rate last Sunday in my going out and coming in, as God gave us 66 souls and 54 of them were in church. 66 souls. And 54 of them were in church, registered in church on Sunday. Radalo, T. Treklaradusha. That's the effect of Operation 6678. We have not prayed into a basket. We have prayed to God that answers prayers. So the supernatural church group we prayed for in July must be delivered in this operation. How many believe that God heard them when they prayed? You believe God heard you? Okay. Now, we are going to divide this spoil. Amen. This operation bring men is operation divide the spoil. Simply, operation divide the spoil. You have overcome the wicked ones sitting on their destiny. Now, go and rescue them. Bring them out of that darkness into light. Bring them out. The power of the wicked has been broken up from off their life. Now, bring them out. Now, bring them out. One of my converts came to me last Sunday and said, Daddy, I don't need anything. I'm happy seeing you. I'm just happy. He said, things are just working. Things are just working. They are not bread and butter anybody. So I've not spent a dime for anyone. Raw salvation. Raw manifestation. Go out there and you see it happen. Now as we are going out today, you are picking them. They are just following you. Now hear me. Somebody today will be going and they call him. Please come. I want to be saved. Somebody will call you, excuse me, don't pass now, I want to be saved. And they're not mocking you. They just see the light you carry and they want to be partaker of that light. Now, that will be your experience at work, in your business places. All through this operation, you'll be amazed at people knocking on your door saying, I want to be saved. People stopping you on the way saying, I want to be saved. People looking at you and saying, I must follow you to church. That shall be your experience. How many excited? Come on, get excited. Give the Lord a shout of praise. 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 In the name of Jesus Christ. Can I tell you this? God who rewards others will reward you. God who rewards the serious will reward your seriousness. God who rewards the dutiful will reward you bountifully. God who rewards the pure in heart will reward you supernaturally. God who rewards the ever self-encouraged, the never giving up souls will reward you openly. God who rewards the joyful in the harvest field will reward you openly. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. So, today, only the joyful are permitted to go out. All others, stay here with me. I'm joyful, but I'll stay with you to steer your joy. Praise God. Only the joyful are permitted to go out. You must get out of this room smiling or they will stop you. They won't let you enter any bus if there is any, except you are smiling. Amen. That's the only way to have a profitable engagement. If there is no joy, there is no harvest. If there is no harvest, you'll be weary with time. So let's be joyful on the prayer altar. Let's be joyful in our going out. Let's be excited about this engagement. Your breakthrough is a product of your cumulative input. Come and say cumulative. It's cumulative. What brings down the stone wall is not the last sledgehammer you threw at it. It's the cumulative effect of the hammer throws. It could be 101 sledgehammer throws. The one that brought it down is not the last one. It's the cumulative effect of all the sledgehammer throws. Somebody's stone wall is about to come down. The wall or barrier between you and God's agenda for the year is about to come down. Maybe it's only these four souls remaining. Bah. One. Thank you, Jesus. Bah. Two. And then, whoa. Three. And then the number four. Whoa. Yeah. And then you take the city. That's how it works. It's the cumulative effect of your engagement that will result in your supernatural advancement. So don't give up. The wall of barrier is about to come down. Don't give up. The wall of barrier is about to come down. Don't give up. The wall of barrier between you and the promised land is about to come down. Don't give up. The wall of barrier between you and your possession is about to come down. Don't give up. Don't give up. Don't give up. Don't give up. In a relay race, you find people, the first man gave it to the second, and they are still number last. The third one, second one gave it to the third, and they are now number five. And they gave it to the last one. Number one. You are nearest your breakthrough than ever imagined. I tell you the truth in Christ, I lie not. Listen to me. The wall of barrier between you and your promised land for the year will come down in this fifth phase. Not a testimony you share, but a testimony that even the blind can see. Your change of position will be the kind that even the blind can see. Your advancement will be the kind that even the deaf can hear. Lift up those two hands, people. Grace for continuity in your engagement until your ultimate breakthrough is released. Receive it right now. Now listen to me. This is our prosperity ministry. But we had our first musical equipment in November 1986. Come on now. We are a clapping church and a jumping church. 1986. Yet, raw encounter with the mystery of prosperity by God himself. He opens scriptures to me that I never read in that encounter. Yet, we were under the grass in 87. Prosperity ministry? What a mockery. Tell me to anybody. But today, what a fortune. You are nearer than ever in my... I took time to say this to you to let you know there's a future in your engagement. There is a clean, clear future in your engagement. You can't be serious about it and not end up glorious. There's a future in your engagement. If you let the enemy discourage you and derail you, it's your fault. There's a future in your engagement. There's a future in your engagement. This is one of the most prosperous church institutions on the planet Earth today. There's a future in your engagement. Keep engaging. And as the Lord liveth, this fifth phase of the wonder of prophetic agenda is your face. Yeah. It will bring the new face of your life out. It will open up the destiny of your family. It will open up the destiny of your business and career. Everything about you must change level in this phase. And so shall it be. We have been flying as a mission for 20 years this year. Yet, it just came suddenly, and no stress to nobody. We have changed aircraft now 3 times within that period. What you are flying today is brand new, never flown, came straight from practice. Never took no offering for this to happen. Sir, keep pressing. There's a future in your engagement. Come on, say with me, there's a future in my engagement. Say it convincingly. I refuse to be discouraged. It is my turn at last. This is my year of golden opportunity. I won't let go. I won't let go. This new operation is changing my position forever. Forever. And ever, I won't let go. I won't let go. This is my opportunity for a change of story, for my change of level. This is my God-given opportunity. I won't let go. I will remain excited. I will remain committed. I will remain serious. I must make it this time. What a platform. What a platform. What a platform for my change of story. May every weary winner come back to Christ. May everyone about to give up catch new fire. May the winner's family bounce back on course with divine agenda. So shall it be. Would you lift up your two hands and thank God for your privilege of involvement, privilege of engagement? Thank you, Lord. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' precious name, please get seated. Before we move out, there are a number of the youth that have their bags here, came from there where they stay for the convention. Please don't leave your bag carelessly. Not everyone that comes to this premises on Saturday is a Christian. Praise God. So make sure your bags are properly kept secure before you go anywhere, if you're going anywhere at all this morning. Or you are advised to be part of the prayer and then move on to your place where you are going. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Tomorrow is our covenant day of vengeance. So market that with all marketing sense. Jesus is bringing judgment down on every invisible force stopping the way against you. Come to this service and see how God brings down the barrier and opens a new chapter to your life. The day of vengeance is in my heart, for the year of my redeemed has come. That is the advertorial today. Tomorrow is covenant day of vengeance. It happens once in a year. This year is now two times, because there are people who still need the vengeance hand of God to be free in their life, to be free from generational curses, free from spells and enchantment. Come over to that service. Why, where God will execute judgment on the forces that are against your destiny. Don't miss it for anything. And then you share the testimony at the back of the flyer. They may not read it. Share it with them. You may not have the capacity to read, interpret it for them. And bring them in. If all you do is to bring them in, leave Jesus to convert them, to convict them in the service tomorrow. Can I hear your amen? Yeah. Don't just throw the flyer. Market the flyer. Market the program. Tell them in a manner that they will know something is awaiting them tomorrow. May you receive that marketing anointing today. Amen. That will empower you to speak the right word. Amen. To everyone you come across. Amen. And bringing them to Christ tomorrow. Amen. So let's make it, as the ones who have had it now, the foretaste of Operation Bring Many. Many of you will come with four tomorrow. Amen. I say, Jesus, before you announce it, I have brought my four. Now that you have announced it, I'll bring another four. You are going. Just be jealous about God. I've lived my life like that all along. Zero regret. Zero regret. I won't tell you when I slept this morning. Zero regret. My life is just going on its own. On its own. And I'm just enjoying Jesus. There are many like that here already. You'll be listed in that army. Amen. Are you excited? So in a moment, we'll be standing up. Amen. Stand to your feet. Has God blessed you this morning? Yes, are you happy that you came? Yes, okay, before we close, all zonal ministers, all district ministers, whatever names you have that reported their absence this morning, please make sure it is forwarded to the provincial centers. Amen. So that we can know who they are by the time the registration is completed and know where each person belongs. Jesus is Lord. We are going with flyers this morning, and we are going also with the advertorial for tomorrow's service, and everything will be speaking. As you look at people, you know which of this currency they will need. This is supernatural breakthrough. I give this to you. This is Jesus still heals today. You have this. Jesus still gives miracle babies today. This is your own, because your own miracle baby is now here. Jesus still rescues people today from things stronger than them. You get this. Jesus still gives miracle jobs today for the weary and almost contemplating suicide. This is Jesus. He's given miracle jobs today. Jesus frees from indebtedness today. This one said to somebody from suicide. The night he was going to die was the evening they gave him this. And came out of that suicidal spirit as if it never existed. So let's go ahead. We're on a rescue mission. Jesus is Lord. Amen. Lift up those two hands. Go in peace. For everyone on the go this morning, the going is declared great. For every one of us staying on the prayer altar, the prayer fire will be the kind you have never seen before. And the answer to our prayers will be evident in the services tomorrow. So shall it be. Together let's share the goodness of the Lord in fellowship. God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the presence of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Peace. From glory to glory, and from glory to glory, we are all getting there. Please, for all those who are waiting on the prayer altar, we are on this side from that point on. Those who are on the go, we are from this side on. Glory to God. And let all sanctuary keepers, we are doing the same job, please proceed to your work platform while the others locate themselves according to the part they belong to today. In the name of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. Now the choir will keep singing our advancement song. Oh, when the saints go marching in. Lord, I want to be in the number when the saints go marching in. Hallelujah.